In this video, we're going to take a look at iPhone mirroring. This was introduced with iOS 18 and macOS Sequoia. Basically, what we're able to do is mirror our iPhone over to our Mac. Not only can we mirror it, but we can also control it from the Mac. Now, this is a feature that I thought, well, would I really use it? But come to find out, I actually kind of like it. Let's see why. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can mirror our iPhone over to our Mac. Let's go over to my Mac and my iPhone. So I have an iPhone 15 here, and it is running iOS 18. That is a requirement to have iOS 18, not to have an iPhone 15, but you do need to have iOS 18 or greater. I also have my Mac here. This is a MacBook, and it is running macOS Sequoia. So those are the two requirements. You need to have macOS Sequoia or greater, and you need to have iOS 18 or greater. Also, what you need to do is be on the same network and be nearby. The two devices do need to be nearby each other. So you're not going to be able to mirror an iPhone from a different city or anything like that. So my two devices here are sitting next to each other. So what I'm able to do now is I'm able to mirror, basically take this and move it over to my Mac. And not only view it, but I can control it. So how do we do that? Well, basically, you're going to see that we have a new app with macOS Sequoia called iPhone Mirroring. And this is in your applications folder. This is just a brand new app. So if I open up my applications folder, you're going to see that I have iPhone mirroring here. So basically, all we have to do is just open that up. When we open that up, what we're able to do is connect over to our iPhone and not only view it, but also control it. So let's go ahead and open this up. So it opens up. We can see it's connecting to my iPhone, and now I can actually view my iPhone. And not only can I view it here, but I can also control it. So I want to switch to a different home screen. All I have to do is just swipe over to the left. And when I do, I'm going to use my trackpad to do this. I'm looking at a different home screen. I swipe back. I'm back at my first home screen. I want to open up the Settings app. I click on Settings, and now I'm in the Settings app. I want to go back to my home screen. Few different ways to do that. I can click on this little horizontal bar here and it'll take me to the home screen. I can also move my cursor up towards the top here, and you're going to see that that window expands. When I move my cursor away, it disappears. Move it back up, it expands. Well, when it's expanded like that, you're going to see that we have a new icon here, and this will take me to my home screen. And then I can also just go up under View here, and you're going to see that I can go to my home screen here. And I can use a key command. So a few different ways to get to your home screen. In addition to that, we can also get to our app switcher. Command 2 if you want to use a keyboard shortcut. Or when we go over to this little expanded window here, you're going to see I have the app switcher here as well. Click on this and it shows my app switcher. Click on this, takes me back to my home screen. If you want a spotlight search, there is also a keyboard command for that. I can go over to Command 3. And if we want to make this window larger or smaller, it makes the whole iPhone larger and smaller. What we do is we just go up under View here, and you're going to see that we can make it larger. Let's go ahead and do that. Now we can see that that window is larger. Let's go ahead and bring it back to actual size. And then we can also make it smaller. And there are keyboard commands for that as well. So I'm just going to bring it back to actual size. And we're going to drag this up here, and now we're looking at my iPhone. Not only looking at it, but I can also control it. So usually what I will do on a second monitor, I will just go and place this over to the left or over to the right, and it's just kind of sitting in the corner. And then I can kind of monitor different apps without having them open on the Mac. So it kind of makes it nice. Something that I didn't really expect to use that much, but I do really kind of like it. Now you'll notice that when you are controlling your iPhone or mirroring the iPhone, the actual iPhone over here is locked. The only way that you can mirror the iPhone is when that is locked. If I were to unlock this, what it would do is it would not allow me to control it here. So if this is unlocked, I can't do anything here. And if this is controlling it or mirroring it, I can't do anything here. So it's one or the other. So let's go ahead and unlock this. I'm just going to swipe up here to unlock it and watch what happens. So I'm going to swipe up. It's going to unlock. And now we can see that the iPhone is in use. So I can't mirror it anymore. Let's go and bring this towards the center here a little bit. Now, if I click on connect here, what it will do is it will wait until this iPhone is locked. It's not going to lock it. You'll have to lock it yourself. So let's go ahead and click on connect here and watch what happens. Click on connect. Now it's going to tell me that it will connect when it is no longer in use. So now what I need to do is I need to tap on the lock button on my iPhone. I need to lock my iPhone. And when I lock the iPhone, or I let it go to sleep, you could just wait here for a minute. When I lock it, then you're going to see that I am able to mirror it. So I just locked it, and now I'm able to mirror it. So again, we can only control it. You can see that it is locked here, and I'm able to control it over here. So that's basically how iPhone mirroring works. There is a setting for this. If we go up to iPhone mirroring in our menu bar on the Mac, and we go over to settings, there's basically one setting here. Do we want to require the Mac login when we access our phone? So if you're in a private area, maybe you're in your office or anything like that, then what you could do is you could have it automatically authenticate. I'm in my office at my home, so I just have it automatically authenticate. If this is a public device or if you're in the public, what you may want to do is set it to ask every time. Then you're going to have to authenticate with your computer password, your Mac password, to do the iPhone mirroring. So there is a little security setting there for that, and it's just located under iPhone mirroring settings. The last thing I want to show you is, in addition to controlling it, we can also use drag and drop. So let's go ahead and open up a new mail message here. I click on it, and what we're going to do is just go and click on a new mail message. Now what I want to do is I want to send an attachment in here. I'd like to send this screenshot here. Well, this is on my Mac. Well, all I have to do is just drag this over to the iPhone. So I'm just dragging it over. And when I do, what it's going to do is attach it to that mail document. So we can even use drag and drop with iPhone mirroring. So that is how iPhone mirroring works with iOS 18 or greater and macOS Sequoia or greater. Basically, what we're able to do is not only mirror iPhone, but we can also control it from our Mac. You do need to have the iPhone nearby your Mac, and it needs to be on the same network and signed in with the same iCloud account. So that is how we can mirror our iPhone with iOS 18 to our Mac with macOS Sequoia. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out my site, danstutorials.com. Although I have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have a lot more videos on my site, danstutorials.com. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? Well, the site is a membership-based site. When you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads of the videos. You also have access to my AI assistant, modeled after an Apple genius. And you have access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. I am just sitting in a corner office of my house that I turned into a studio. Actually, it's a spare bedroom that I turned into a studio. So when you become a member of my site, you are directly supporting a small business. You're directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.